happened, Mom. I know he's not around, but don't you place the blame on me as you pour yourself another drink.
I went in head first, never thinking about who what I said hurt in what verse. My mom probably got it the worst, the brunt of it, but as stubborn as we are, did I take it too far? Cleaning out my closet and all them other songs, but regardless, I don't hate you, cause mom, you're still beautiful to me, cause you're my mom. Though far be it from you to be calm, my house was Vietnam, Desert Storm, and both of us put together could form an atomic bomb, equivalent to chemical warfare, and forever we could drag this on and on, but agree to disagree. That gift from me up under the Christmas tree don't mean shit to me. You're kicking me out? It's 15 degrees and it's Christmas Eve. Little prick, just leave. Ma, let me grab my fucking coat. Anything to have each other's goats. Why we always at each other's throats? Especially when dad, he fucked us both. We're in the same fucking boat. You'd think that'd make us close. Further away, it drove us. But together, headlights shine and car full of belongings. Still got a ways to go. Back to grandma's house, it's straight up the road. And I was the man of the house, the oldest. So my shoulders carried the weight of the load. Then Nick got taken away by the state at 8 years old, and that's when I realized you were sick and it wasn't fixable or changeable. And to this day we've remained estranged, and I hate it though, but
I guess we are who we are. Headlights shining in the dark that I drive on. Maybe we took this too far.
Cause to this day remain estranged, and I hate it though, cause you ain't even get to witness your grandbaby's growth. But I'm sorry, mama, for cleaning out my closet at the time. I was angry, rightfully maybe so. Never meant that far to take it though, cause now I know it's not your fault, and I'm not making jokes. That song on the longer play, it shows, and I cringe every time it's on the radio. And I think of Nathan being placed in a home, and all the medicine you fed us, and how I just wanted you to taste your own. But now the medication's taking over, and your mental state's deteriorating slow. And I'm way too old to cry, this shit is painful though. But Ma, I forgive you, so does Nathan, yo. All you did, all you said, you did your best to raise us both. Foster care, that cross you bear, few may be as heavy as yours, but I love you, Debbie Mathers. Oh, what a tangled web we have. Cause one thing I never asked was where the fuck my deadbeat dad was. Fuck it, I guess he had trouble keeping up with every address. But I'd have flipped every mattress, every rock and desert cactus, own a collection of maps and followed my kids to the edge of the Atlas. Someone ever moved him from me, that you could've bet your asses. If I had to come down the chimney dressed as Santa, kidnap him. And all the one has only met the grandma once. You pulled up in our drive one night as we were leaving to get some hamburgers. Me, her, and Nate, we introduced you, hugged you, and as you left I had this overwhelming sadness come over me as we pulled off to go our separate paths. And I saw your headlights as I looked back, and I'm mad I didn't get the chance to thank you for being my mom and my dad. So mom, please accept this as a tribute. I wrote this on the jet, I guess I had to get this off my chest. I hope I get the chance to lay it for him dead. The stewardess said to fasten my seatbelt, I guess we're crashing. So if I'm not dreaming, I hope you get this message that I will always love you from afar. You're my mom.
I guess we are.